The evolution, I never would have thought that I would see someone like Sheng Tsung out of Foxy. And it's until you talk to Foxy, and he always gives me the same reasoning why he picks a character. I'm like, Foxy, you picked up Sheng, and he goes, yeah, man, I can throw a Lupinato shimmy, and I'm like, oh, that makes sense.
He has, I mean, he can throw, obviously he has the keep away game, but we're talking about Sheng. This is an aspect of Foxy's game that I've been very excited to watch. So we've been talking till the cows come home about his Sheng Tsung and this new character he's picked up. He by no means has dropped Kung Lao. They are a pairing. This is like the alternate universe Shaolin Monks, when it's not Liu Kang and Kung Lao, and it's Sheng Tsung Kung Lao, and Liu Kang's the bad guy. But of course, that's why it's important, right? If there are matchups he prefers, for example, I think we might see if he fights a Geras player. You know, Kung Lao, I think, does quite well against Geras, and it's one of the only matchups that I think Sheng Tsung players say they quite dislike. But right now, Sub-Zero might be one of them, and Foxy is going to start off immediately with the down three on hit into the throw. That is one of the Foxy classics. And we've talked for days about how his Kung Lao works, and I really feel like it's just rinse and repeat at this point, right? It's throws, it's mids, it's Z-hat setups, it's dive kick whiff punishes, it is the entire...
Oh my goodness.
Oh, disgusting.
You're right, we can talk about it every day and we can break it down, but the thing is that it doesn't change, it's super effective, and we just saw it on display right there.
Well, we can talk about how he's been playing Sheng, but we can't, you know, forget that obviously this Kung Lao is top three major pro competition events back-to-back. Top three at CEO, top three at Viennality, and Kung Lao only. So you know, there's no way he's just going to stop playing.
He has top eight at every single pro competition event so far.
I believe he's the only player that can boast that.
Yes.
The only player to make top eight at every single pro competition event. At least the offline majors. Anyway, Foxy looking quite one-sided so far. There's a throw tech into the down three and a really well-timed down two. I really agree with the decision to neutral duck. It's so dangerous to do that against Kung Lao, but on a hit down three when you're a couple of throws away from death, that's definitely a good time.
That is. But you know what? I actually like what everyone went for right there. Went for the 50-50, tried to reestablish himself in this matchup, but not paying off. We actually saw earlier on stream a Sub-Zero not go for that and actually end up costing him a match. I like that he went for it, just tried to establish himself, give him a little bit of breathing room, but unfortunately, one mix-up away. And that's all it takes sometimes.
Well, unfortunately as well, looking at how Foxy defended against it, like, he didn't fuzzy low to high, he was just stand blocking. He was you're gonna do
just,
it. It's gonna happen. And unfortunately, that's exactly what was provided. And that's already one game up. Sub-Zero again. Sub-Zero getting quite a lot of representation at EVO. Obviously,
a lot of Sub-Zero.
Yeah, also
a lot of Kung Lao out there. Both variations. Just a Perfect Legend earlier. Rock, he looked just like MKX Perfect Legend. Orbital hat and everything, teleporting in. It was awesome to see.
Yeah, and that's actually why I quite enjoy watching Kung Lao. I feel like the two Lao variations cater to two very different kinds of player, right? You've got kind of like the more calculated, methodical Kung Lao that's, you know, I suppose a slower style, which is definitely more of a Foxy Lao. And then you have, obviously, Lotus Fist, which is a bit more of the chaos, very airborne, very teleport happy, and the orbiting hat to make teleports even stronger. And I like it. I like it when the variations do that and they let multiple styles work with the character.
I've seen a lot of use of down three out of Foxy Grandpa so far, just checking everything that he can. And what's great about that is all he does is throw out that down three and hit or block. He has something ready for both options every single time he does it. And look at these conversions, maximizing their damage. No big drop right there to Foxy, still picks it up into, I would expect none other than Foxy to drop a combo. Oh, throw.
I honestly feel like Foxy is one of the best players in the entire scene for hit confirming the low pokes.
Yes.
It's hard to do that, right? Single hits like that. Oh, and there it is, the Fatal Blow scoured out. Foxy Grandpa chooses not to use the Crushing Blow off the forward two. Not necessary. Wants to keep it and just go into the spin instead. Which means that Foxy's going into match point with a lot of resources still left. And wow, just the raw Z-hat. And Edwin just spacing a little bit too far away. Right now, I feel like he's got the right idea. It's just not quite at the right range.
Here we go. This is going to give him something here. Throw. Oh, looked like an input error right there. Actually got an instant jump normal, and Foxy all over it. Now he's going to reestablish himself, and once again, that down three just checking Edwin from really doing anything. And how many times is the Z-Hat simply going to outspace Edwin? Plus frames on deck.
The issue is as well, like when you're getting those kind of errors, like, oh, and there it is, the wake-up Fatal Blow. As much as I'd want to say this might not matter, it is Sub-Zero, and he does have offensive meter, so this can be a huge chunk of damage to potentially start a comeback, but Foxy has got a defense. Good throw. Okay, this is going to give him advantage too. It is the front throw. Oh, the scoured out. Okay, no,
confirmed. No commitment.
I mean,
if you're going to die in that situation, you might as well, right? Of course, Foxy Grandpa gonna do the throw brutality to start things off here.
I honestly think Foxy has like the most throw brutalities on stream in pro competition events of like anyone in the world.